Hello and welcome. We're coming to you today from the most polluted city in the world. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about football. More specifically, India's upcoming international friendly against Jordan. And discussing this vital, vital issue with me today is a man who you know as the rising star in the Star Sports presenter stable. I know him as a man who can eat his way out of any situation and the finest midfielder to never have played for India. Mr. Arjun Pandit.
What's happening, buddy? That was very good introduction. I wasn't expecting that, to be honest. the best midfielder part, you had me at best only.
कहाँ से आ रहे हो भाई साहब?
भाई साहब हम आ रहे हैं चेन्नई से आ रहे हैं, where the third T20 international was played between India and the West Indies, and it was a good game because David Silva scored a good goal, and then Martial got the equalizer. But then I was happy because I don't like United that much because we're Arsenal fans. I had no work, so I was watching the Manchester derby. See the baat.
So Manchester derby छोड़ो, अपनी derby की बात करते हैं.
यार see, the game against Jordan, first and foremost, I think we should put our hands together for the AIFF that in the space of a month, you've got the Indian team playing two games against really top quality opposition, right? First came China and now comes Jordan. Yeah, seriously, give credit where credit is due because these are the kind of games you have to play before the Asian Cup. Aisa hi aapka aapko opposition milega at the Asian Cup. So there's no point playing versus a Sri Lanka, Pakistan and so on and so forth, and no disrespect intended to them. But Jordan, in my view, will possibly be the closest we will get to playing a team like Bahrain. If you remember 2011 Bahrain, when we played against them, they were tall, strong boys, you know, big guys, 6 feet tall. A majority of them, their average height was about 6 feet tall and all. So I'm guessing Jordan is the closest to that. So it's going to be a very physical encounter. And as opposed to China, it'll be interesting to see the way Stephen Constantine sets his team up. Let's be honest that the team exceeded expectations. No one was expecting them to play the way they played against China. And it didn't seem like, you know, they were shooting in the dark. They had planned for it and they executed his plans beautifully in China. Versus Jordan, ab dekhna padega yaar, because team news mein ye sunne ko mil raha hai in reports, is that team captain Sunil Chhetri might not be playing this game owing to an injured ankle. Yeah. Which, if the reports are true, then it's a good decision because you'd rather have him fully fit come the first week of Jan, yeah, as opposed to now versus Jordan. Yeah. But yeah, so it'll be an interesting game.
How much of a difference do you think that makes, irrespective, just because, you know, we had a situation and the reports also indicate that Chhetri's injury is not serious. So hopefully this is just a precautionary measure and nothing more than that, because that's a 2011 we were talking about.
Yeah.
And Bhaichung wasn't
exactly
back then at his, yeah, he had recurring injuries going on. But the minute you saw him come onto the pitch, even against, was it the last game against Korea?
Yeah, the last game. Yeah, he came off the bench.
He came on for like the last
game. And like Bhaichung comes on, boom, he came on, you know, full power.
But more than him, the transformation that the team went through the minute this guy came onto the pitch, suddenly is like there was a new energy and a new sort of sense of purpose about these boys. You know, ki kuch, suddenly they thought ki it's possible.
Hamara bada player hai yaar. Our biggest player has come on the field.
So do you think Chhetri is in a very similar position with the current national team?
Of course, yeah. Chhetri is way ahead of any player in this team, and I mean it with the utmost respect for every other player on this team. What Chhetri has done and what Chhetri has done consistently over the years and what Chhetri has been doing over the last 2 years is not like Chhetri apne naam pe chal raha hai. He was the standout player in the ISL last season, Indian player. He is the standout player for Bengaluru this season as well. He's already got, I think, 4 or 5 goals to his name, yeah?
The injury was also after he
Injury was also after he scored. He played the full 90 after that, and I'm guessing after the 90 they assessed his injury. And Bengaluru said, look, thoda issue hai. And I'm guessing they were, you know, in contact with the All India Football Federation, who of course were in contact with the coach. And then if they've taken the decision to rest him, then you've got to welcome that decision, yeah. Because you'd rather have a fully fit Sunil Chhetri in UAE as opposed to a half-fit Sunil Chhetri in the UAE and not have the same situation repeat itself. Because Bhaichung was at the fag end of his career in 2011. He did not recover from his calf, but Bhaichung did not have was the professional approach that the ISL teams are giving to their players. They're
and
giving
this
him.
This boy is at his peak now. Yeah?
He's at his peak right now.
He's playing like he's.
But it's also his last big international tournament.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we're not going to the World Cup.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But you know what, this also means is that since there's no Chhetri, it means there's an opportunity for the likes of JJ and Balwant Singh to stand up and be counted. But as they say with goal scorers, that in the build-up to a game, your form defines the kind of, you know, the kind of momentum you're carrying into it. And momentum for a goal scorer, to have that touch, to have that feel for a goal is so important. JJ has not had the best of starts to the ISL. Balwant has not had the best of starts with ATK in the ISL. So my only worry is that where are the goals going to come from? Zyada chance milne nahi wale. Udanta Singh has not had the best of starts to the ISL. No goal, no assist to Udanta so far in Bengaluru FC's campaign. The only guy who seems to have had a decent ISL is Holly Charan Nazri. But Holly Charan Nazri playing international football is a completely different scenario as opposed to Holly Charan Nazri playing in the ISL. Pranoy Haldar is a good midfielder. You need someone like that, combative midfielder. He's shown that in the ISL. Rowland Borges used to be a mainstay for Stephen Constantine up until about a year and a half back. He was probably one of the first few names on that list. He's come down the pecking order, but he's had a good start to the ISL again. Last season he was injured, so didn't have the best of seasons. This time around, the Rowland of old has come back in. Anirudh Thapa, his team has not had a good season, but Anirudh Thapa, as we saw in that game versus China, brings in a freshness into that midfield. You know, he brings an air of positivity, his ability on the ball. So that should be good. But the big talking point for me is the defense. Yeah, Anas. He's our two stopper backs, Sandesh and Anas, of course. Anas hasn't featured in the ISL so far. So he's practically going into that game versus Jordan with no real game time under his belt.
No match sharpness, no. But he has this sort of connection with Sandesh.
Yeah.
I suppose the idea is to, if he's not the national team coach, can have no real say on what his ISL team does. He can at least give him game time when he has a chance. Right?
Yeah, but you can't say that it's not going to have an effect or a factor on the way he plays for the national team. Because if you're playing five games prior to that with the club team, yeah, then you come to play one game with the national team. Of course, what you do in those five games will have a big impact. Momentum is huge in football. Your rhythm, everything develops over time. Now, the big question is really,
When did Anas come back from injury also? He hasn't been fully fit for...
He hasn't been fully fit for a while. He didn't start the ISL. He had an injury. Yeah, I think it's been a while since he's come back to full fitness actually. But the big question really is, do we have a reserve pool? Right? This close to the Asian Cup, do we have a reserve pool of getting in new players and saying, okay, maybe these guys are not in full form for their club teams. Should we get players who are doing well for their club teams and bring them into the national team? And my answer is no, you don't. You're practically two games away from the Asian Cup. You've got your 30-man squad ready. Yeah. You cannot bring in new players now, which means if a Susai Raj is doing really well for Jamshedpur FC, I'm sorry, but he just does not fit the scheme of things now. It's too late now. You can't do it now. If this was 6 months pehle, then maybe you could have said, okay, yeah, Susai Raj. If Susai Raj was playing the ISL last season and he performed the way he was performing for Jamshedpur, then yeah, probably you would have seen him in the 30-man squad. But because he was playing the I-League last season, then you had to see him step up and see whether he could do it in the ISL. And now that he's doing it, but it's too late. Yeah. It's just a timing issue, I think. So I don't think you can bring in new players.
Yeah, this, I mean, like, so we can, of course, a separate discussion is on whether the ISL is actually a step up or not. I think if you see the quality of a player, especially a young player, 22, 23-year-old player, who was playing the way he was consistently over the course of a season against big teams, small teams, all kinds of teams, like Susai Raj is last season. I think there's enough there for a coach to say, okay, why not give this guy a shot, see what happens next season. So anyway, but what's done is done. What you're saying is basically ki team pakki hai.
Team pakki ho gayi yaar.
Yehi bande khelenge.
Ab bas matlab wo 18 ya 20 ladkon ki squad nikalni hai for the Asian Cup. Ab aapko bas pick and choose karna hai, who is my best player in form right now. And I think in his mind, he's already chosen his 18-20 man squad. He's just going with 30 because aapko option milta hai 30 ladkon ko lane ka, and you can so of course see them in practice. And it keeps the others on their toes as well. So it works that way.
To your other league point, my thing is just that I think neither or no league competition, no club competition in India is of the standard where like you can really take those performances into serious consideration when it comes to the national team playing a major tournament like the Asian Cup.
Agreed.
So it's pretty much like, matlab, the coach has no choice but to go with what he thinks is will be the best 11 he can put out. That's
fair
that's
enough. But the thing is, see, whether or not you agree with me, if the ISL is the best quality of football in the country, even if you're not Stephen Constantine, you're any coach, you're going to choose from that talent pool that you have playing in the highest level in the country.
Yeah, but the sort of the competitive fixtures for them to prove that they are good enough to play at the higher level. I mean, if, like you're saying, if I were the coach, if you were the coach, you'd go with the guys who you trust and who you've built into some kind of a unit already.
Yeah, and the unit has been performing for a while now. Yeah. So that trust factor is there. You know, it's not like he stop gap, chale ja raha hai, kabhi haar rahe hain, kabhi jeet rahe hain, kabhi haare ja rahe hain. They've put together a good run of wins, yeah. And after that performance versus China, it's kind of validated a bit as well. So now, will the same thing happen versus Jordan? I don't know. Because Jordan could be a completely different approach, and if you go onto the field without Sunil Chhetri.
By the way, are you going to break the news to us first? Is Star Sports showing the game? Is that already decided? Last time it was like a last minute decision ki yaar, ab ye 3 billion potential sort of audience wala match hai, to dikhane ka time hai, to ye wala bhi dikha rahe hai? Yeah.
Next question.
Sorry, go on.
No, but no, my point was just that. Yeah. I think it'll be a real test for us to see how we do without Sunil Chhetri. Yeah. I think that is the big talking point, and how this team manages without Sunil Chhetri. How someone like a JJ steps up. Yeah, because JJ's goal scoring form has been on the wane for a while now. It's been from last season of the ISL, and it's carried on into this season as well. And especially when you have Chhetri in the form that he is, you can still sit back and say, okay, I can be provider. You know, I can provide and I can play in that triangle for Udanta, Chhetri and JJ. But if Chhetri nahi hai, ab Balwant aayega. So Balwant, JJ aur Udanta ka combination kaise chalega, ye dekhna padega. Because all this while, we have not taken into account what if something happens to Sunil Chhetri. 34 साल का तो है and I mean it, I know.
क्यों जिंक्स कर रहे हैं?
नहीं, मैं जिंक्स नहीं कर रहा, मैं टच वुड यार, I hope nothing happens, man. We know him personally also, great guy, great player. But what if something happens to Sunil Chhetri? फिर क्या करोगे आप? फिर are you depleted completely? Are you depleted completely going forward?
We'll see. I mean, I definitely think it makes a massive difference. Like he is the best player.
But he has that Bhaichung effect, like you said, no?
Yeah, yeah. He has an effect on his teammates. More than his ability on the ball, his brain is fully there. He's always, I mean, his work rate is phenomenal. There's literally nothing about the guy that is, that takes away from this Indian team.
Yeah.
So, but that said, I think with nothing to lose also, a guy like Balwant, whenever he's gotten a chance for the national team, he's gone and done something.
Yeah, he's gone and done something.
Right?
True.
So, kya pata bhai, maar de 35-yard cracker, maza aa jayega.
Yeah, but main bas keh raha hu ki wo probability bahut kam hai. Because jo striker hai, striker apne momentum pe chalta hai. Ab agar aapke dono jo top striker hain, within the first few games of the ISL, I think 5 ya 6 games ho gaye, usme un dono ne zyada kuch kiya hai nahi. And you define a striker, of course you look at the striker and you see his work rate and you see how he's combining with the team and all. But the ultimate definition of a striker is through the amount of goals he's scoring. And both of them have not been scoring too many goals.
Agreed.
So that's an issue.
Yeah, it depends. Like my take is just that in this case for these guys, like the playing for the national team, a lot of things change. Yeah. Overall, like, the cohesiveness of the team, the quality of players in every position. I mean, in a small pool of players, the national team here represents an overall much higher standard. Like these 30 boys, if you were to make a club side out of them and play against even the foreign players who are currently playing in India,
I think they
would do all right. So it's safe to say that given that situation, an improvement in performance. Of course, you have to also consider the fact that the opposition is far superior.
Yeah.
So it could be that these defenders, and I don't know Jordan so well that I can comment on whether against those specific defenders, whether Balwant or any of these guys actually have any chance at all.
Yeah.
So,
but you brought up Jordan. Just for the people who are watching, what is the team made up of? How many European players? How many players
there's
from the local
they have
league?
One young player, a guy called Musa Al-Tamari.
Musa Al-Tamari?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's 21 years old and he's playing at Apoel Nicosia in Cyprus.
Hmm.
Which is a club that is a reasonably big club.
Yeah, Apoel, I think, plays
Champions League, Europa League.
Yeah.
So, I guess he's their biggest talent. The rest of them are mainly from two clubs, Al-Faisali and Al-Wehdat. Between the two of them, they've almost won like 50 league titles domestically. So, most of the players are from these two big clubs, the Derby of Jordan clubs.
Also, I think Jordan ka, their last game was versus World Cup finalists Croatia, 2-1. They lost, but since we keep focusing on the last game, I think it's very important to focus on what they've done over a long period of time. So, over the last 10 games, they've played three European opposition. So, they've played Croatia, they've played Cyprus and they've played Denmark. And this is not ki ek game, do game. It's come over a period of 10 games. Uske beech mein they played Asian opposition. So, you're playing a squad which is well-oiled and which is sorted, seasoned squad. So, I think this is going to be a...
Obviously, they are planning for... Like, I guess they are looking at the Asian Cup as a maybe potentially winnable competition or looking to get to the last stages maybe.
Yeah.
So, their preparation has to be...
But I don't get it. Okay, I'm going to ask you, what do you think? China would have been a tougher test or Jordan is going to be a tougher test? And don't take into account what we did in China. I'm just saying on paper, if you would have been seeing that India is going to China to play China and then to Amman to play Jordan, which for you would have been a tougher test?
Both tough games, yeah. I don't know how we can compare, but like the Chinese men's team hasn't done anywhere close to as well as the Chinese women's team has done.
Yeah.
And somehow... Because of the, I guess, the positivity and there is a positivity associated with how the national team is doing right now, right? Not too many defeats, you know, it's a, there's a belief, I think, that against most opposition, they can put in a good effort. Baki jo hoga, wo hoga. China also, they cracked the bar a couple of times. It's a game we should have lost. We would have, might have lost on another day. This will be a similarly tough situation, yeah.
I think this is going to be a tougher test, yeah.
I think thoda planning theek karni padegi or you thought the plan was well executed. I thought like the plan
to the best
was,
of our abilities.
Yeah, perhaps.
To the best of our abilities, that's what I'm saying. You can't execute a plan over 90 minutes, but you can execute it for say 60 minutes or for batches of 15 minutes. Football mein to waise hi hota hai na, up and down chalte rehta hai. Kabhi you have momentum for 5 minutes, kabhi they have momentum for 5 minutes. It's what you do when you have momentum on your side or when your backs are against the wall, that's what counts. Ball trap karna har koi janta hai. Sab janta hai ki wo andar jayega to main yahan se overlap karunga. Ye to hum bhi karte hain. Hain? Par iska matlab ye nahi ki execute kar paate hain har bari. You know, in a match situation, it's a completely different scenario here. So that's that, and then after this is one
and
game.
Definitely, like I'm sure the crowd in Amman will be like really
pumped up. Huh?
Yeah, yeah. I think everyone knows now it's pretty close to the competition, and it's going to be a fun game. Definitely.
Should
looking
be a good
forward
game.
To it.
I'm looking forward to it.
So for you, the couple of Indian guys that you will be watching particularly, and hoping that they fit into the system.
For the trio. Of Balwant, JJ and Udanta, how they function without Sunil Chhetri. That for me, I'm going to have a keen eye on. The defense, just not because something new is happening, but just how they can continue with that consistency that they've been showing at the international level. And like in the last game versus China, I saw it was not hadbadane wali defending. You know, ki ball aage uda diya, maine Bangladesh, yahan maar diya, maine Sri Lanka. It was, you know, Sandesh was coming into his own. He was taking over the player. One-on-one situations, he was sometimes getting better of the Chinese players and all. So, it remains to be seen if they can do the same versus a physical,
again,
physically strong Jordanian side.
Different strengths.
Gurpreet, of course, with the kind of performances he's been giving over the past couple of years, you've come to expect a certain kind of performance from him. So you'd hope that Gurpreet continues doing what he does. And really, it's just, I want to see the kind of tactics they imply, man. Is it going to be the same thing of ball mili, counter pe bhago, 1, 2, 3 touches, triangle pe, and move forward? Because, mind you, Jordan would have seen video of the game versus China, right?
Yeah.
Jordan would have seen video of the game versus China, and China did not have the benefit of seeing a game that India played versus tough opposition like them, and to see the kind of opportunities and the kind of tactics they employed. So, if anything, I think Jordan will be prepared for that. And if that happens, what sort of a pragmatic approach does the coach use during the game? And does he have, you know, the bandwidth? Does he have the kind of players with the tactical know-how to change their system during a game? That is what I'm going to be looking at. Yeah. Of course, goal maare, but I don't know. Yaar. Mere hisab se goal thoda scene thoda mushkil lag raha hai. Thoda mushkil lag raha hai. Jaise hamare safed baal yahan se hamare sar se chale jayenge, mushkil lag raha hai. Waise hi mujhe thoda goal bhi thoda mushkil lag raha hai.
और इस ज्ञानी नोट पे
डाई लगाओ बाल काले करो.
में एटलीस्ट एक कैमरा पर्सन है जो सोने वाले हैं, तो वील टेक दैट एज अ पॉइंटर एंड रैप अप दिस डिस्कशन. वील डू इट अगेन एंड द नेक्स्ट टाइम वील बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द टूर्नामेंट, द एटमॉस्फेयर ऑफ अ मेजर टूर्नामेंट. होपफुली मिस्टर पंडित विल जॉइन अस अगेन.
वी आर नॉट रिव्यूइंग द गेम.
वील रिव्यू द गेम, या बट लेट्स सी हाउ इट गोज फर्स्ट. इफ इट्स अ 7-0 टाइप सीन, देन लेट्स स्किप द रिव्यू.
Don't think it's happening to 7-0, man. I mean, that's negativity right there for you.
Yeah.
Man.
No, I don't think it's happening either.
Huh.
I don't think it's happening either. I think it'll be a... Oh, chal, score prediction.
Score prediction? Yaar, maine na apni zindagi bhar logon ko maine predict karne ke liye force kiya hai. Kyunki nature of our job is ki journalist... Sir, prediction. You know, we always do... It's the most stupid question ever on the planet, I feel. Sorry. But since you're asking me for a prediction, I'll say
stupid is as stupid does.
Yeah, I'll say it's a Jordanian win. I can't give you a score, man. I don't know a score. I think Jordan's going to win this, but I'm not bothered about the result. Like I said, after China also, I'm just bothered about the way we play and what we do.
Yeah, I think it would be great, sir, if we could get a goal. I think it'll be a massive boost.
That's a good point.
Baki to chalta rahega thoda bahut jo bhi hai. Weaknesses will remain, मतलब वो तो over the course of 2-3 games वो तो बदलने नहीं वाला है. But अगर एक goal मार दें at least, थोड़ा confidence और आ जाएगा.
I think
it'll be a step forward, I think, in to whatever we're
trying. एक और बात याद आई यार, थोड़ा चांगटे को खेलने का मौका मिले यार. Because in the ISL also, I was seeing a couple of games of Delhi Dynamos. Yeah, that boy looks transformed there. And transformed not because उसकी game बदल गई है. There's a certain amount of self-belief that has come into himself, that he knows ki I can take on players. Physically, he's really worked on himself. You can make out he's buffed up a little bit. He's become a little broad and he moves well with the ball. I think maybe, I'm not saying Chante should be starting for you. If Holicharan Nazri has been your main guy, then you start with him. But give him 10 minutes, give him 15 minutes, 20 minutes,
yeah.
And let's see what Chante can do, man. Because if he's a part of your 30-man squad, then he deserves to be given a chance. Yeah. He's been doing so in the club.
Let's see what he's got.
Yeah, let's see what he's got.
All right, Mr. Constantine, it's on you now, sir.
Yes, sir. We'll be watching.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you again.
I don't think he'll be watching.